Amen, amen, amen. Come on in, everyone. Let's go ahead and begin to pray in our heavenly language this afternoon. Shikaramo horoshe. Come on, let's get this atmosphere charged up. Amen. Shikarararara shikororoshe. Mara shikarararararararararashe. Horoshe diarashe diarashe. Moroshe diarararararararararashe. Horamarararara. Come on, let's charge this atmosphere up, you guys. Shidiarashe kororoshe. Marashe diaramokoroshe diarashe. Come on, let's pray. Come on, let's get stirred up in the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Hallelujah, glory, yes, God. Amen. Let's praise him. Hallelujah. Come, hallelujah, and praise him. Glory God. Hallelujah. Let's give him praise. Come on, some of us hurting on here. Some of us are going through some warfare. Let's praise God today. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God. Hallelujah. You're so wonderful, and you're so worthy. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Let's give him praise this afternoon.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen, amen. So today's prayer topic is peace. Some of you guys need peace. Amen. We all need peace. We should be walking in peace. And if you're not walking in peace, you know something is not right. Amen. So we're going to be praying for peace. And we're also going to be praying as the Holy Spirit leads today on this line. Amen. So, Father God, we just thank you, God, for peace today, God. God, we just humble ourselves, Lord, this afternoon, God, as we come together corporately, God, and come seek your face. We know that you are here. You said in your word, where two or three are gathered, you are in the midst. So, God, we know that you are right here, God.
Yeah.
And, God, we know that, Lord, that when we have needs of stuff and when we need things, you know what we have need of before we come ask of you, Father. And, God, there's people on here that don't have any peace because they don't have a job, and they're believing, God, for finances, God. There's people on here that don't have peace, God, because of relationship problems. There's people on here, God, that don't have peace because chaos around them, things are happening around them. There's people on here that don't have peace because of distractions. There's people on here that don't have peace because of believing you, God, for healing, or they're believing you, God, to meet a certain deadline. But, God, I just ask you, God, today to give each and every one of us peace concerning the circumstances that we are up against, concerning the challenges, God, that we are facing every day. Give us supernatural peace that surpasses our understanding on here, God. Lord, because we know that when we have your peace, God, everything, God, is going to be better than okay. We know that when we come to you, God, and you give us peace about the situation, you got this, God. You're working on it, God.
Lord.
You are moving for each and every one of us behind the scenes, God. God,
yes,
it's just
Lord.
A matter of time for it to suddenly manifest. It's just a matter of time for the breakthrough happen. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
So, God, we come together today, decree and declare 2 Thessalonians 3:16, that your peace, God, will be with us in all times. In all times. I prophesy that in each and every one of our lives, that the peace of God
Lord.
Will be with us in all times, in every way. And the Lord is with us. Come on, somebody, say it out your mouth. Say, the peace of God is with me at all times. Say it out your mouth.
The peace of God is with me at all times.
Come on, every way. In every way. Say it out your
mouth.
In every way.
Come on, say, the Lord is with me. The Lord is with me.
The Lord is with me.
The Lord is with me. Thank you,
Come
Jesus.
On, that's right. You got to say with confidence. Amen. I don't care if the enemy has you cornered this season. I prophesy God is going to make an escape route. Amen. Just for each and every one of us. I don't care if your back is up against the wall on this line. Amen. God is making a way for us. I'm telling you, God is going to show up. He is our holy defender. Amen.
Yeah.
He is our holy defender. He is our protector.
Glory.
And God
has each
and every one of us on his mind. God has each and every one of us on his heart. God has a miracle with our names on it. But
Thank
I prophesy this afternoon that we're not going to fret. Amen. We're not going to fall apart.
We're not going to toss and turn
at night when we should be resting at night. We're not going to lose our appetite over the situation. We're not going to have anxiety attacks. We're not going to get any more gray hairs because of worrying about stuff that's out of our control. I decree and declare today that we're going to rest in God. We're going to rest in God. We're going to receive His peace. We're going to walk in peace. We're going to breathe peace. We're going to lay down in peace. Come on, we're going to, I'm just telling you, peace is going to surround us in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I decree and declare, we're not going to even worry about the bad reports. We're not going to even worry about things that's out of our control because God got it.
We're not worried.
That's right.
God got it. And I decree and declare that those bad reports you see today, that God is turning them things around for each and every one of us.
Turn it around, Lord. Turn it around.
I don't care if you got served to go to court. God's going to move in that courtroom. I don't care if the bill collectors are harassing you. God's about to move and He's going to increase you and cause you to go to another financial status as you obey Him and be faithful as you trust
Thank
Him.
Thank you, God. Yeah.
I don't care what the doctors are saying. You're going to have supernatural peace because you know God is a healer. Amen. I don't care what it looks like. If you don't got no food in your house, no gas in your car. I decree and declare you're going to have supernatural peace. You're going to say, you know what? God has me. I'm not going to worry about where my next meal is going to come from. I trust God.
Right.
I prophesy that in someone's life today. Amen. That you're going to have peace. That's the path of our understanding.
Peace. Amen.
Peace. Because God is with us all times in every way.
Yes.
Amen. God is with us at all times. His peace is. Jesus is the Prince of Peace. Jesus is the Prince of Peace. He specializes in peace.
Yes, he does.
Come on, somebody right now, you're stressed out about your job. I decree and declare it'll be a peaceful, environment for you in the name of Jesus. Somebody's stressed about your household chaotic, but I prophesy things are lining up in our homes, that our homes will be peaceful in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, in the name of Jesus.
Come on, I bind up fear. I bind up anxiety right now in Jesus' name. God is not giving us a spirit of fear. God is not giving us a spirit of fear. We should be walking around afraid of everything. Well, I prophesy we're going to have peace. When the enemy tries to threaten us, you're going to have peace. Amen. When the enemy tries to tell lies and stuff, we're going to have peace in the name of Jesus. We're not going to even be moved. We're not going to even be shaken. We're not going to even be bothered in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare
peace.
I decree and declare we won't be anxious. We bind up fear.
Yeah.
You on this line, you dealing with fear, let's lay hands on your gut today. And let's tell the spirit to come up and out now. In Jesus' name. Amen. Don't follow it back down.
Fear.
If you got a purse, go purge. If you got to go spit. If you got
to
go yawn. That spirit got to come up today. Amen. Because my God is for you to be fearful. God, uproot fear. Uproot fear out of our guts. We command the spirit of fear to come out of our guts. We command the spirit of fear to come up out of our glands. We command the spirit of fear to come up out of our minds. We
send
you an official notice, spirit, come up, 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 out.
Lord,
we have on the fire of God to touch you.
In the name of Jesus.
You got to come out today. Amen. I feel somebody yawning on here. Go ahead and yawn. Let that stuff out. Amen. Because where God is taking us, we don't have time for fear. Where God is taking us, we don't have time to be doubting or being double-minded. Where God is taking us, we don't have time to be down in God. No, we're going to walk in peace. Peace is our portion.
Walk in peace.
Peace
is our portion. Come on. I decree and declare Philippians 4:6 that we will not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. We're going to let our request be known unto God, and God has
it. Let it be known.
Come on. We prayed about this thing. Amen. We're going to trust God to move for us. Whatever it is, you prayed about the house. We're going to trust God. Amen.
Thank
to make
you,
a way
Lord.
For
Thank
that house.
You,
we're going to trust God to make a way for the car. We're going to trust God to make a way for the families to get restored. We're going to trust God to move for you on your workplace. We're going to trust
God
to turn it around. We're going to trust God for your deliverance. We're going to trust God for your healing.
You're
not going to be anxious, amen, about anything.
No, not be anxious about anything.
About nothing.
Yes, yes.
Come on. Jesus said in his word in John 16:33, amen, he says, I have said these things to you, that in me you will have peace. Come on. Our peace comes from Jesus.
Said.
It comes from Jesus, amen. Come on. The world is looking around for peace, but they don't have what we have as believers, We got peace from him. He is our source. All right?
Thank
he
you,
says,
Lord.
In this world we're going to have tribulation. In this world we're going to go through trials and crazy storms crazy circumstances, but he told us to take heart because he has overcome the world. So we are overcomers through Christ Jesus.
Overcomers.
Look around today. I'm talking to somebody on this line today. Look around and you see your trials and tribulations. You're getting ready to overcome it. You can't rejoice. Amen. Whatever you're going through today on this call, look around at it and say, you know what? I'm going to overcome this through Christ. I'm going to overcome. Come on, this eviction. I'm going to overcome this sickness. I'm going to overcome this divorce. I'm going to overcome this separation. I'm going to overcome being broke. I'm going to overcome not having a job. I'm going to overcome this warfare. I'm going to overcome these trials and these tribulations. I'm going to overcome this legal battle. I'm going to overcome, come on, these nightmare terrors. I'm going to overcome whatever's coming up against me. I'm going to overcome it through Christ Jesus.
Yes, we're overcomers.
Come on. You better be confident about this word. Amen. The faith of God rising up.
Yeah.
Amen. We are overcomers. I don't care what the enemy's plotting and scheming. We will overcome it in Jesus' name. I don't care what lies the devil has told us. We will overcome it in the name of Jesus.
Yes, I will overcome it.
Open up your mouth today and decree and declare that you will not be shaken. So I will not be shaken.
I will not
be
shaken.
Come on, say with confidence. I will not be shaken.
I will not be shaken.
I will not be shaken.
Stop crying over things that are out of control. Stop crying over every little thing and put your foot down today and say, I will not be shaken.
I will not be moved. I will not be moved. Thank you, God.
Come on, say it like you mean it.
I will not be shaken.
That's I will not be moved. In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
I decree and declare Isaiah 26:3 on this line today that God will keep us in perfect peace. Come on, perfect peace. Whose mind is set on him.
Peace.
Amen.
Perfect
peace. That's beyond that's peace beyond human understanding, human intellect. That's peace that just surpasses all understanding. It just don't make sense. We just got a bad report and we got perfect peace. We just got fired on our job and we got perfect peace. Something just came at us, but we got perfect peace. I decree that in each and every one of our lives.
Because
our mind is stayed on Jesus. Amen. We're not gonna be moved.
Cannot be.
We're not going to be distracted.
No,
we're not going to fall apart.
Hallelujah.
We're not going to waver in our faith.
No,
we're not going to be double-minded.
Can't be like a double-minded.
I decree and declare perfect peace on this line today.
Perfect peace.
Thank you,
Jesus. Come on, lift your hands up and decree and declare, receive it. I will have perfect peace.
I will.
I will have perfect peace.
emotions.
Perfect
Come on,
peace.
Speak over
yes.
your emotions. Some of you guys are allowing your emotions to rule your life. Amen. You're sad one day, then you're melancholy
yes.
all throughout
yes.
the week.
Yes.
And then you're just
yes.
so negative throughout the week. Come on, that's not the will of God.
Not
Come
the will,
on.
Not his will.
We're supposed to be counting it all joy. Amen.
Oh,
we're supposed
God.
To be rejoicing about
it's
this
all
thing.
Joy.
Listen,
yes.
when the enemy mess with you, we should be counting it all joy. We should
count
be rejoicing at this thing. Come on,
count
in the name of
joy.
Jesus.
In
Tell your emotions,
all joy.
You don't run me, but I run you. Come on,
yes,
speak over
emotion.
Yourself. Amen.
You don't run me,
but I run you.
That's
Thank
right.
You.
Amen.
Some of our emotions are running our lives. Some of our emotions causing us to go into the cave and go into a state of depression, but we break that today in the name,
yes.
of,
in the name
Jesus.
Of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
God is not, that's not the will of God for you to be crying all day. Come
yes.
on, man.
No.
Yes.
Uh-uh.
Come on. He's the Prince of Peace. Jesus is the Prince of
yes.
Peace.
Yes, he is.
He
longs to give us joy, and his presence is the fullness of joy. So we're in the presence
yes.
of God while we cry all
Thank you,
day.
Lord. Thank
we're
you,
in the
Lord.
Presence of God while we're sitting up here melancholy and all sad and depressed and negative and just nasty
yes.
rude. Come on.
Right.
I promise
on
God to get in the presence of God so we can receive supernatural joy.
That's
yes.
right.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
So my decree, our mind will stay on Christ. The problem is some of us are not keeping our minds on Jesus. Our minds are focused
right.
on the bills more than Jesus. And that's when anxiety sets in. Some of our minds are focused more on the problems than it is about God. And now we're all
yeah.
stressed out and sad and depressed. No, I prophesy today that our mind is going to be recalibrated. That our mind
Jesus.
Is coming to alignment with the word of God.
Yes,
that our
yes,
mind is focused
yes.
on Jesus. That our mind is going to get supernatural strength today to hold on, to keep fighting. Some of you guys,
yeah.
you took your eyes off of Jesus. You took your eyes off the cross, and now you're sad. Now you're depressed. Now you're heavy. I bind up any heaviness today on this line
in the
yes.
name
yes.
of Jesus. And
in
I decree and declare that our minds
are
so. Stay on
it
Christ.
So.
Come on. Our minds
yeah.
are going to be
yeah.
focused on Christ as never before.
Oh, glory
That's right.
to God.
As never before. That we have that
yeah,
perfect
right.
peace. That we're not going to even be moved. I don't even care
right.
what the devil doing. We will not be moved. We will show
no
ounce of fear.
Yeah.
We will show
yes.
no ounce of even
yes.
worryness.
Yes.
God, we're going to
yes.
say, you know what? God has this. Oh, well.
God
got
it. No weapon formed against us will prosper. Come
That's
on.
Right.
No weapon formed
right.
against us will prosper.
None.
In the name
None.
Of Jesus.
No weapon. No weapon.
But we're not That's prosper. Right.
Come
yeah,
on, they look like
not.
A corner, but it's not going to prosper. It's not
we're
going to get the advantage of us.
That's
and
right.
Man,
no,
we
right.
win. We win.
We,
Why
yeah,
we
yeah,
let
yeah,
people
we
say
win.
About us, steal our peace? Why we let these people
yeah.
get underneath our skin? Why we let
That's
these people
right.
get on our nerves, stealing our peace? Peace is a
yeah.
gift from God. We're going to keep
is.
The peace. Amen?
Keep the peace.
Yes, we
keep
are.
The peace. Keep the peace.
Come on, lift your hands. I'm going to cast all my anxieties on him because he cares for me. Say it out your mouth.
I'm going to cast all my anxieties
all
on him because he cares
him.
For me.
He
Come
cares
on,
for me.
I'm going to cast my anxieties on him because he cares for me.
I'm going to cast my all
cast
my anxieties on him because he cares for
him.
Me.
He cares
Come
for
on.
Me.
Everything you're going through today, come on. You're worried about your education. You're worried about your children. You're worried about your spouse. You're worried about the bills. You're worried about how this all come together. Let's cast it on him today. You just said it out your mouth. Come on, we're going to
yeah.
cast it on him today. Amen.
Yeah,
we're going to say, here, Jesus,
out,
we're going to give it to you, God. I ain't going to walk around here being heavy.
Out,
I ain't going
to
walk around here being sad and depressed. I'm not going to walk around here feeling discouraged. I'm going to give it to you, God. And God,
it's on
you,
Lord.
It, God. I can't
yes.
change this individual, God.
You handle it, Lord.
You can,
yes.
God.
Yes.
I can't, Lord, change the circumstance, but you can, God. So, God,
yes.
I'm going to give this to you today.
Yes.
Come on, cast
yes.
your care. All those anxieties on him. Everything that got you worried. Everything that's coming against you to steal your peace today. Just give it. Just surrender it all. Say, here, God, I surrender all.
It's on you, God.
I surrender all
today, God.
I can't walk around here feeling depressed. I can't walk around here being wounded. I can't walk around here not living my best life. I can't walk around here, God, you know, attacking and lashing out of my frustration on other people. The devil is a liar.
Nope.
Some of us are so wounded and so hurt and so bitter that we're lashing out at people, the people that love us the most. We're getting an attitude with our husbands. We're getting an attitude with our wives. We're getting an attitude with our children. We're mistreating people because you don't got no peace because you're not happy. But I bind up just us being miserable
yes.
today in Jesus' name.
Yes.
We will no longer
Jesus
be
name. Jesus
we will
name.
No longer be bitter. We will
no
longer
be
right. scorn. We will
no
longer
no
be
longer.
Angry. We
yes,
will no longer
God.
Just doubt
no
God
longer.
Anymore.
No
Amen.
Longer.
We will
no
longer.
No longer.
Amen. We will
yes.
cast
no
it all on Jesus today.
Jesus.
Cast it
Jesus.
All on Jesus.
To receive
Thank
peace.
You.
Somebody on this
yes.
line mad at God. Amen. We can't be mad at God for things
That's
that were
right.
our fault. We can't be mad
That's
at God
right.
if you really want to be real for our disobedience. God told us
That's
not to
right.
do that.
That's right.
God
That's
set
right.
us
mm-hmm.
out in the beginning, but you were hard-headed.
Mm-hmm.
You were full of
That's
us.
Right.
You
That's
were
right.
full of rebellion.
Mm-hmm.
And you did.
Yeah.
You mm-hmm. thought you were big and bad, so you did things that were outside of the will of God. We got
That's
to own
right.
up to
mm-hmm.
our mistakes, and we
got
to repent.
Got to
and say, you know what, God? Yeah. You know, I repent for getting mad at you. I repent for blaming you. I'm going to
yeah.
look in the mirror. Amen. And I'm going to see the log in my own eyes instead of trying to see the speck in my brother's eye. I'm going
That's
to do
right.
what is
right.
in my eye, Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
Do a work in me. I'm talking to somebody on the blind today.
Work,
do a work in us. Do a work in you, God.
To get peace.
Yes.
I prophesy this afternoon. We're going to love on ourselves. We're going to appreciate ourselves. Amen.
Yes.
We're going to see ourselves work on this line today. In
Jesus'
name. So much we don't value ourselves. We don't value the gifts and the talents that God placed on our lives because we let the wrong people in our circle. We let the
That's
wrong
right.
people speak in our lives. And now we're
That's
stressed
right.
out. Now we just discombobulated. Now we're double-minded. Now we don't even believe the promises of God because you let the wrong people speak in your life. You let the
Come
wrong
on.
People hand in your vision. You let the wrong people around you. Come on,
That's
talk
right.
to somebody. We got to reevaluate our circle. Amen.
Re-evaluate.
Not everybody deserves
That's
to
so
be
true.
In our inner circle. And not
That's
everybody
so
deserves
true.
To have a
Amen.
Seat at the table.
That's
Amen.
Right.
Everybody
You're right.
Just deserves to have a seat at your table that God's preparing.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Right.
Somebody. Some of us don't
Amen.
Got Jesus. The wrong connections. The wrong relationships.
Yeah.
Come on, Lord,
mm-hmm.
I ask you, God, today. I know it's hurtful, amen, but God, remove these people that don't even mean us any good out of our lives. Remove
them. Yeah,
remove
them out
of
my life, God.
Remove them, Lord.
Remove from my
remove
life that don't mean me no
remove
good.
Remove the opportunists, God. The people
yeah.
that
remove them, too.
For names. God, the opportunists
yeah.
that want to use us,
remove
abuse
them
us,
come
us dry.
Come on.
Like a
That's right.
Remove the opportunists, God.
Yes.
Remove the Judases out of our lives. Remove the people
Judas
that that's on the
yeah.
that covet what we have, God. But when opportunity arises for them to attack, they'll attack us in a minute. Remove these people out of our lives. That
remove
was
them, God.
Wounded and depressed. Remove these people out of our lives now.
Yes,
in
Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I'm trying to hold on to people that God's trying to remove. I'm talking to somebody.
I know that's
right. I said
right.
it yesterday.
I know you're right.
Amen.
Let
them,
you
Stop
did.
Trying to hold
you
on
did.
To these people. Come on.
Yeah.
Just let it go. Let it go.
Let
them
go.
Them go.
That's
and
right.
And so
God
can move to the right people. God's not going
right.
to see your husband when you're holding on to this bongo in your inbox.
Okay.
It don't do you any good. Amen.
God All right.
is going to
see
your
wrong.
Wife.
That's
Amen.
Right.
When you keep messing with these strange women.
Come
Amen.
On.
That's right.
going to pull you further away from God.
That's
right.
God's going to see you the right mentor. And the right connections and the right opportunities when you're still holding on. And God told you to disconnect a long time ago. I'm talking to somebody
Amen.
On the line
Amen.
Today.
That's right.
Thank you, God.
You're wondering why you don't got
mm-hmm.
peace. Lord, we thank
mm-hmm.
you, God, for obedience today.
Thank you
for
obedience,
today.
Lord.
That
yes.
we listen to you, God. We focus on you, Jesus, as never before. Lord, God,
yes.
I thank you, Father God, right now, Father.
Thank
that,
you, God.
We will be peacemakers. We are peacemakers.
Yes.
Amen. But they should be called the sons of God. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
I decree and declare we come to make peace. I don't care if everybody
peace.
Else around us, God, is full of gossip and drama. I prophesy that will not be our portion. I prophesy
right.
we will not be messy. I prophesy
nope.
we won't feed off the negativity. Some of us like to feed off the
no,
negativity. You can't wait to sip on the next cup of tea. You can't wait to find the latest gossip. You can't wait, you know, to see the next scandal break out. You rejoice. You use people's names to get followers. The devil is a liar. I'm talking to somebody. Amen? We ain't going to do that. No. I prophesy this day that we will be peacemakers. Amen? And that God
will
give us just wisdom. And because each and every one of us, we have the ministry of reconciliation. And we will restore the fallen back to the body of Christ. I'm talking to somebody
Amen.
On this
Thank
line today.
You.
Amen? We will be peacemakers. Amen? We're not going to be gossipers.
Lord.
We're not going to be person instigators. We're not going to be slanderers. We that's not going to be us. Amen. We should be
Lord.
Called the sons of God because the scripture says in Matthew 5 and 9, blessed are the peacemakers, for they should be called the sons of God. Point
that's
to
right.
yourself.
Yes.
And then say, I'm a son and a daughter of God.
I am a son.
I am a son and a daughter of God.
Amen. Say, I'm a daughter. If you're a man, Amen. So I'm a son of God.
Yeah,
amen.
I'm a son
amen.
Of God.
I'm a daughter of God.
Amen. We are peacemakers. All
peacemakers.
Right, in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Come
Hallelujah.
On. Prophesy this out your mouth. Say, I'm going to live peaceably with all men. I'm going to live peacefully
going,
with all men.
I'm going to live peacefully with all men.
I'm going to live peacefully with all men.
Come on, I decree and declare. Come on, we don't have time to be arguing about things. We don't have time
yes,
to be having, you know, Facebook wars, Periscope wars, YouTube
mm-hmm.
wars, you know, just bashing somebody else's
yeah.
name. And come on, that stuff looks foolish. That stuff looks, that grieves the
yeah.
spirit of God. When we
yeah.
hashtag and call people out and just go
mm-hmm.
to war, people arguing and fighting on some status and fighting,
Social.
Going war to war. That's
yes,
not
God.
I declare we will let people be with all men. And come on,
yes,
certain conversations
God.
Are beneath us. Certain
That's
conversations
true.
Don't
Hallelujah.
Even deserve a
That's
response.
Right.
The devil don't
Amen.
Even deserve a
mm-hmm.
response from some of us. Hey,
Amen.
That's right.
You know,
no
I
response.
Care what the devil, I don't care who the devil's using. Amen. Certain times when the devil speaks to certain people, they don't even deserve a response. In Jesus' name, I'm not going to even give the devil a satisfaction of just letting him know how it affected me. I'm not going to give the
no
devil the satisfaction
yeah.
of letting him know that he really made me upset and angry.
Right.
I don't even
okay.
deserve a response. I'm going to go to God. I'm going to go. Come on. I prophesy we're going to go to
Hallelujah.
The one that defeated the devil in the first
yes.
place.
Come
Amen.
On.
Come
on.
Amen.
She come to you, Lord.
Yeah.
Amen.
Come on, we're going to live peacefully with all men. Amen.
I
prophesy in this season, no mess will attack to us. No scandals will attack
no,
to us.
No,
no drama will attack
man.
To us. Amen. I decree and declare
man.
That we have a good name because a good name is better than gold. Amen. A good name is better
Amen.
Than some good ointment in Jesus' name.
Yes.
That
Amen.
When people hear our names, they will think good things. They will think highly of us. They will esteem
yes,
us
right.
highly in
Hallelujah.
The name of Jesus.
In the name
I decree
of Jesus.
So in our lives. That we're going to live peaceably
yeah.
with all people. If people don't want to
yeah.
live right, then we'll give them the boot. We'll show them the exit. We'll show them the exit. Amen. In Jesus' name. We don't have time
yeah.
to be attached to people that are full of drama and mess
That's
and
right.
causing division.
Right.
We don't have time to be attached to
That's
agents
right.
of Satan, people that the enemy is
That's
using.
Right.
We don't have time to be associated with that because bad company corrupts good moral or good
That's
character.
Right.
We don't have
That's
time
true.
For that
yes.
foolishness. I prophesy.
No,
amen.
We don't.
That certain conversations are beneath us because we got to keep our peace in Jesus'
yes.
name.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank
Come
you,
on.
Lord. Thank
Say
you,
this
Lord.
Out your mouth that I'm going to turn away from evil and do good.
I'm going to turn away from evil and do good.
Come on, say it again. I'm going to turn away from evil and do good.
I'm going to turn away from evil and do good.
Then one more time. We're going to get this in our spirit, man, today.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to turn away from evil and do good.
I'm going to turn away from
evil and do good.
I'm going to
turn away from evil and do good.
I'm going to say this out your mouth. I will seek peace and pursue it. Amen, amen, amen. Say it again.
Amen.
I will seek peace and pursue it.
I will seek peace and pursue it.
Amen.
Come on, one
yeah.
more time. We're going to be peacemakers. No more drama.
I will seek peace and pursue it.
Amen. I decree it so we
Hallelujah.
Are peacemakers.
It is
amen.
So. It is so. Yeah.
Come on, we
Hallelujah.
Belong to God. We belong. We represent
yeah.
Christ on this line today.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Yes.
We represent Christ. We're not going to be
yes.
agents
That's
of Satan.
Right.
The devil
Come
will
on.
No longer use
That's
us.
Right.
Amen.
No longer.
The devil will no longer be glorified through our
no longer.
Actions. Amen.
In the
no
name
longer.
Of Jesus.
Amen.
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 I prophesy purity on this line. That
yes.
we will
yes.
have
yeah.
Thank,
that our
agenda
will be
yes.
pure in the name
yes.
of Jesus.
Lord,
and our
Jesus
will glorify God in the name
yes.
of Jesus.
Yes, God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name
come
of
on,
Jesus.
I decree and declare that the God of hope will fill us with all joy.
Yes.
And all
yes.
Come on.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank
that
you,
God
Lord.
That God will fill us with all joy and all
Thank
peace
you,
and believing.
Come
on, so that
God
is
will
power.
Fill us with all joy
power.
And all peace.
Come on, that the Holy Spirit may abound in hope.
Yes.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Come
on, Romans 15:13, that the God of hope will fill us with all joy and all peace and believing. So by the power
yes.
of the Holy Spirit, we're going to
yes,
abound
God.
In hope. Come on, we're going to
yes.
abound in
yes.
hope.
Abound
in
hope.
We
Jesus.
Abound
in
hope.
In the name of Jesus.
We abound
Thank
in hope.
You, Lord. Thank
Come
you, Lord.
Come on, hallelujah. Come on, some of
yes,
us,
God.
We got to press in a little bit more. We got to press in. Let's go deeper
press,
in the spirit.
Press.
Let's go
yes,
deeper
God.
In prayer.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Push.
God
That's
knows
true.
That you're in debt.
Come on.
God knows that the bill collectors are calling you. God knows your deadline. He knows that your bill is due. Come on the first. God's going to give you the grace. I'm talking to somebody. God's
about
to send a supernatural grace period for
you.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
Come on.
Thank you, Lord.
The grace period. You missed the first deadline. You said, God, the bill was due on the first. A couple of days went by. But I prophesy, God is right now for like two people on this line right now. This word is for you. That God is giving you a supernatural grace period.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you for the grace period.
That He's gonna provide the funds right now in this grace period
for
you.
Thank
you,
Lord.
Grace period.
You're
gonna get the funds. Amen. Telling you. If you receive this word, you know it's for you. You're going to have peace right now. Peace is coming upon you right now. And you know that God's going to come through for you.
Hallelujah.
God's going to provide this great period for you.
Yes.
And you will not lose anything. You hear me?
Thank you, God.
You will not lose anything. I don't care. You will not lose anything.
Hallelujah.
Your car will not get a success. You will not get evicted. Whatever you owe. Your phone will not get cut off. And then
Hallelujah.
Your water won't get cut off.
Hallelujah.
Your utilities will not get cut
off.
You,
your television
Amen.
Will not get cut off.
Thank
your internet
you,
will not get cut off.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
I prophesy
you
supernatural
Hallelujah.
Attention in
thank
Jesus'
you
name.
Thank you, Lord.
We're not going to fall apart.
Thank
God has
God.
This. God
Hallelujah.
Has this. Come
Hallelujah.
On, prophesy this afternoon.
Thank
the
you,
cycle of struggle and lack is season in Jesus' name.
Thank you, God.
Oh,
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I receive it.
Thank you.
Glory hit me. My God.
I receive it.
Amen.
Come on.
I receive it.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Frustration and struggle is coming to a
halt.
Yeah, God.
In Jesus' name, I decree it so.
Amen.
Come on.
Thank you, Lord.
You're not going to worry about bills no more. I told you this over and over and over on this line today.
Right.
I told you guys, clean your cars on this line.
Yeah. No
amen.
Amen.
Just look at those bills and say, God, these are your bills.
Amen. These are your bills. Have
God. Your bills, God.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to tell you that. Amen. God, these are your bills. Why are we crying about these bills when we serve God? Come on, we serve
Amen.
God.
Yeah, yeah.
We live
right.
for God. Amen.
That's
Come
true.
On.
That's true.
He's
that is true.
Box. Come on, you have bosses in the natural on our jobs. Amen. Whoever you work for. But we know when God is your boss, he's the best boss. He's
Amen.
The best compensator. Amen. God's about to supernaturally compensate
true.
Us. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
God.
Thank you.
I decree that so in the name of Jesus.
God,
if you have
I
an assignment, if you have a purpose, if God told you to do something,
Ooh,
amen, just get ready to be compensated. I decree
Ooh,
that in the
Lord.
Name of Jesus. Get
I
ready
receive
for the
it.
Back pay. Get ready for
amen.
The overflow.
I receive
get
it
ready
too.
For the glory of God to overtake you.
Yes,
get
Lord.
Ready for the miraculous. Get ready. I'm
yes.
telling somebody on this line today.
Yes.
We're going to believe
yes,
God.
Yes, God, I'm ready.
Yes.
I know they get crazy when you don't have any credit and you get a car. Come on. But you're going to have peace about it too. Amen.
Yeah.
I know they sound crazy when you don't have they have the finances or the resources or a good credit report, but you get approved for that loan for the house. I'm talking to somebody.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
You're going to have peace about it. I know it may sound crazy. Amen. You don't even have the right qualifications or the credentials, but you get supernatural favor and you get up there anyhow.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
You're going to have peace about this thing that we believe in God for.
Amen.
Amen.
I know it may sound crazy when you're outside of your comfort zone and God tell you to do something that has never been done before. God tell you to do something that you have never done before, but you're going to have peace about it in the name of
Amen.
Jesus.
Thank
Amen.
You, Lord, for peace.
Come on, never again will we doubt God. Never again will we fall apart when something don't make sense and it goes beyond our natural understanding.
Right.
Never again will we just trek. Oh, come on. I decree and declare we're going to rest in God.
Yeah.
Rest in God in the name of Jesus.
Yeah. Rest in God.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on, I decree and declare we're going to strive for peace with everyone, for the holiness without which no one will see the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Without holiness, no one will see the Lord. Amen. Hebrews 12 and 14. We're going to strive for peace. Amen. We're going to strive for peace.
Oh,
amen.
Man.
There will no longer be mess around us. Amen. People
no,
will say, you know what,
amen.
Prophetess don't play that, or a pastor don't play that, the man of God don't play that, the woman of God don't play that. Never again will people disrespect the anointing on your life. Some people around you cursing. They don't reverence the God in you. But I prophesy the tables are turning. Times are changing. Amen. Nobody
amen.
In their right mind, I don't care what devil's operation, they're going to reverence the God in us. Amen. Just like Jesus,
amen.
He walked in so much authority. that the demons recognized who he was in the spirit. They knew who he was. They didn't curse around him. They bowed down before him. They bowed down and say, oh, son of man, you know, did you come here to cast us out? Did you come here to torment us? But I prophesy this afternoon, we're about to walk in such a level of authority that those demons in operation and these people around us, they're going to halt and recognize the authority and the glory of God on our lives. And they say, you know what, excuse me for cursing. And they're going to feel uncomfortable. Some demons and people that's in operation, they're about to get cast out this season. Amen. I prophesy that cast out anointing in this season. That we're going to cast out some devils in this season. So we can have peace in our environment. That person that's coming against you every day, I prophesy that the Holy Spirit, his boldness is going to rise up inside of us. We're going to look that person in the eye and say, Satan, come up out of this person. Satan, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. You will have peace. I'm talking to somebody today. Somebody on this line. You've been harassed every day by this wicked woman that's full of demons. But I prophesy, amen, that next time they get in your territory, the next time they get close to you, oh, those demons are going to manifest. You'll say, come up out in Jesus' name. Come up out in Jesus' name. You can no longer steal my peace. You can no longer steal my joy. You can no longer use this woman on my job. You can no longer use my husband against me. You can no longer use these children against me. I'm talking to somebody.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Come on, I prophesy boldness on this call. Are you ready for this? I prophesy boldness on this call. We are called to be demon slayers. Come on, point to yourself. Say, I'm a demon slayer in the name of Jesus.
I am a demon slayer
in the name of Jesus.
In Jesus'
name.
Come on, if people don't want peace, if people full of the devil, and they're trying to disturb my peace, either you're going to get these devils cast out of you, or you're going to get out of my territory, get out of my way. In Jesus' name. Come on, prophesy over yourself. Say, I am on assignment. I am on an assignment. In Jesus' name.
I am on assignment in Jesus' name.
Yes, come on. Lord. So a lot of demons about to get cast out in this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We're not playing around. Amen. We're about to see the power of God. I decree. We're about to see the power of God flow through us in another dimension if you want it.
Thank you,
Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. You're about to see the power of God flow through your pores in another dimension. I'm telling you, your aunt and your uncle coming against you. Amen. They're going to have to bow down to the name of our all names, Jesus Christ. They're going to get those devil cast up out of them because we're not playing this season. We're not playing this season. Never again. What we worry about is just having stress and just chaos in relationships because people are just disorderly and just crazy. I decree and declare no matter where we go, we're going to have peace. Amen. I don't care if someone's trying to come and shoot up the movie theater. They will not be able to shoot up the movie theater because a man of God's there, because a woman of God's there. I don't care if somebody's plotting to shoot up the school. They will not even be able to come 50 yards in that school system. In the name of Jesus. I don't care if somebody's plotting to shoot up Walmart or shoot up a store. They will not be able to shoot it up because you are there. Because we are there. Wherever we go, we take the kingdom of God. We take the kingdom of God with us. Amen.
Yes.
And when the kingdom of God comes, there is no harassment from the agents of Satan.
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying to you? When the kingdom of God comes, all of hell waves the white flag to surrender. They say, we can't handle this glory.
Thank you.
We can't handle the presence of God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, my God. We are no match for God's kingdom.
That's the truth.
That's
come
right.
Come on, I'm talking
no
to somebody
man.
Today.
No
Amen, that's true.
Come on, raise your hands up today on this call. Amen. So I'm going to be a glory carrier in Jesus' name.
I'm going to be a glory carrier in Jesus' name.
Come on, prophesy of yourself. Say, when I show up, the kingdom of heaven is showing up. In Jesus'
name.
When
I show
up,
the kingdom of heaven
has shown up in Jesus' name.
Come on. I prophesy we're about to be atmosphere shifters for real. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I don't care. I don't care what the devil's plotting. I don't care who the devil is in. When we show up, the atmosphere bows down. Amen.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
What's in us is more powerful than what's in them. You hear what I'm saying to you?
That's right. That's right.
The God in us is more powerful than the false God.
That's the truth.
Come on, the low-ranking demons and other people.
Glory.
They don't know
glory. Come on with
that's
that.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
I'm gonna say it again. I feel fire burning in my gut on this word. The God in us is greater, higher, is more powerful, more mightier than these false gods and these little demons, these little imps in operation, and other people that are in our enemies. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
So when I prophesy, we are atmosphere shifters in Jesus' name. When we show up, heaven is backing us. When we show up, the atmosphere has to shift. When we show up, it'll be a peaceful environment.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. In Jesus' name.
There won't be no chaos. There won't be no tragedies when we show up on the scene.
Yes.
Amen.
Come on. Amen.
Thank you,
God. Amen. It'll be peaceful. I don't care if somebody's an alcoholic. Amen. The demons in that person, if they're a violent person, they will submit. Amen. Yes. In Jesus' name. Because they know that we have Christ in us. They know that we're here in heaven. I'm talking to somebody today on this line. You better receive this word.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
God, he doesn't want us to be powerless. He wants us to be powerful in him.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying to you?
Yes. In him, yes.
How many people around you got to stay bound because you don't do your job?
Right.
I'm talking to somebody.
Right.
Mm. How many people around you got to stay oppressed with the devil because you don't want to open up your mouth and receive that, the things that God has for you? Come on, we got to give an account. Talk to somebody here today. Take authority. Take authority today. Amen.
Yes,
my home is peaceful. My home will stay peaceful. Come on, there's a providence in this home. Amen. Come on.
Amen.
You're a man of God. Say your home's going to be peaceful because you're the priesthood of your home. You're a woman of God. Say your home's going to be peaceful because you are a child of God.
Man. My home's going to be peaceful because I am a child of God. Amen.
We're going to handle disrespectful children.
No,
come on.
No,
we're going to have
Hallelujah.
Bad marriages. We're going to have no bickering and fighting and strife in our home.
No.
Come on. We got to take authority in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Things are lining up. And you know what? Don't even say it's okay. Some people are like, it's okay. No, it's not okay.
It's not okay.
You know what?
That's
the
right.
Holy Spirit lives in the inside of us. And this is His temple. Our body is His temple. Nobody curses around me. You better take this stuff out on the street.
Amen.
But when I'm here, amen, I'm bringing the kingdom. Good, you feel uncomfortable. Good. Because you feel the presence of God coming
out
for you. Good.
That's what it is.
Amen.
Come on. And let me tell you about a man named Jesus. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Amen.
I decree peace and peace.
Come on. I decree and declare peace. We breathe peace. We walk
I decree
peace.
Peace.
Amen.
Yes.
Peace is around us. Peace saturate us.
Amen.
Wherever you're going to today, know that God has it. I feel peace on here today.
Amen.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Stop worrying about stuff that's out of your control. Say, here, God, take it. I put it on my altar today. God, I give it to you today. I ain't going to be stressing about this thing today. I give it to you in Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Come on, release it. Release.
Yes.
Release.
I release it.
Whatever this thing is, release it today.
In Jesus' name.
Come on. If you agree with this prayer today or this word, come on. Just say amen and release it. I feel fire on you. Release
it.
Amen.
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 Release it.
Amen.
Amen.
I release
it. Release it, Lord.
Yeah, release it. I tell you guys every day, stop letting these people get on your nerves. Stop letting these people get underneath your skin. Come on, release it.
Amen.
These people ain't worth to take. Some of these people are not worth holding this much power over our lives. Come on, our mental capacity, holding up space in our minds and the heart.
Amen.
Yes.
We want to release it today in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Just to do what you're called to do. Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
Everybody on here is called. Everybody on here.
Yeah,
come on,
amen.
Yes.
You got
Thank
something
you.
To do. Your life has
Thank
purpose
you.
And meaning.
Amen.
Get
yes.
busy. Get busy.
Yeah.
I'm here
amen.
To empower you. Amen. Get busy.
Yes.
Stop looking at your titles. Come on, just say, you know what, God, I can tell somebody about Jesus today. Who told somebody about Jesus today?
Amen.
Let's get quiet.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Half the day went by. Amen. So you still got another 12 and a half hours to tell somebody about Jesus today.
That's right.
Amen.
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 Yes.
Come on, don't let this day go by without hashtagging Jesus is Lord or telling somebody about Jesus.
Somebody,
amen.
Come on. So I pray something was said to bless you. If you want to bless the ministry, you can go to my website at prophetessk.org or go to Cash App, $ProphetessKim. We got amazing things coming up. We got the write a chapter in one of my upcoming books, amen. I almost died. If you have a near-death experience or you almost died, I would love to have you share your testimony in my book, amen, because we're doing some awesome things for the Lord, amen. We're going to evangelize. We're going to have professional interviews, a magazine interview, and some other great stuff, amen. So the deadline for that is next month, January the 27th. Also, we have a mentorship program that's also open, 3 months of mentorship with me. Amen. We're going to do ministry. I'm going to teach you guys all the ins and outs and the supernatural and everything that I'm doing. I just want to pour into a select few. All right, God told me to focus on women this season, so that's what I'm going to do. All right, and that starts February the 6th. So I would love to impart, equip, amen, God told me to make disciples. Amen. I think the beginning of this year, so this is part of my discipling process. All right, so anywho, I want to get some real praise reports. I'm telling you, yesterday, praise reports, God just blew our mind. I mean, just the lady that testified about the car, and her credit was in the best. And I'm like, my God, if God did it for her, just know that you are next. And the other lady, she testified about just how rats were just biting her. And now, you know, God wants her to get in a better house and get a better job. And I mean, some powerful testimonies. My God.
Amen.
So just know
Amen.
That you are next. And as
Amen.
We testify,
Amen.
We are giving the devil a black eye. You hear me?
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. We are overcome. I'm telling you, the enemy is overcome. The enemy is overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony.
Word,
Amen.
Amen.
So
Amen.
Give the devil a black eye and let's testify. Don't tell me a praise report. Excuse me, don't tell me a prayer request disguised as a testimony. Some of you guys are like, oh, and you just want prayer. No, nope, we just want real testimonies in this portion before we transition. Amen?
Amen.
So we have a
testimony. I have a testimony, Prophetess.
Okay,
remember when I called a couple of weeks ago and I shared with you about Aaron with the two kids, her aunt left her before she transitioned? And so, anyway, you were praying for those kids, and one of the things that I remember, you were praying for them to have a close relationship with God, to get to know God. And I want to tell you how fast God moved, that one of the twins, the 12-year-old boy, I have to read you the text. The 12-year-old boy said to his aunt, which is Aaron, who's taking care of them now, said, Mickey said he's going to start a prayer group with some of his friends because they have 15 minutes in the morning before prayer and they are going and they aren't doing anything. And I'm
say that part again because their phone was distant.
You
about to start a prayer group?
Okay. She texted us because you were praying for the children to have a close relationship with God. And I even told her, you know, to start have Bible studies with them. And so anyway, she said that Ricky, which is the boy twin, came to her and said he's going to start a prayer group with some of his friends because they have 15 minutes in the morning before class.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, a 12-year-old, he's going to start a prayer group 15 minutes before class starts.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Jesus.
That's a blessing.
That and that's the prayers of the righteous avail as much.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
That is so powerful. because he's so young, you know. We need to see more children on fire for God. I love that.
Yes. Absolutely.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. Powerful. That has made my day. Amen. I love it.
I love it too, prophets. I kept trying to get on this call, and the enemy was just like every day I had something I needed to do, and before I knew it, I missed the call. I would get on and hear a little bit, but I said, I'm going to give this testimony there. I stopped on the side of the road.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for sharing.
I bless this call. God bless this call, God.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Somebody needs to know your child is next to be on fire for God. Your child is next. Amen. My children are next. Amen.
My grandchild is next.
And your grandkids, that's right. Your nieces and nephews.
My children are next. My grandchildren, yeah.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's powerful.
Hallelujah.
All right. The next praise report.
CG, God bless you, Papa. God bless everybody.
Amen.
I got a day off and I'm on the line. Amen. I just want to share. On this job I'm on, I know God is working. Not just, you know, it's for me to have a job, but there is harvest there and it's plentiful. And I was getting ready to put eye drops in one of my patients' eyes. He was involved in a motor vehicle accident where the car rolled over, and it fractured his left femur, his left thigh bone. And it happened earlier. I thought it was fresh, but it happened, he'd say, on the 11th of November. So he's at rehab hospital, and when I took the iPad off his eye, immediately out of my spirit, because I had, you know, I don't do this like that, but when I looked at his eye, I say, in the name of Jesus, heal this eye. And then I'm like, girl, what are you doing? Because, you know, they don't want you saying nothing about Jesus because people are so easily offended, and they're, you know.
Right.
But anyway, I'm telling you, my spirit just leaped, and that came up out my mouth. I put them eye drops in. And do you know, after I did that, God told me he was going to supernaturally heal this man. I asked him later on when I went back to there, I say, is your eye feeling better? He said, everything feel better. He said, I just feel good.
Amen.
Then the other day, he said, I want you to pray for me. And little he know, I had already prayed and had a word from the Lord. I was just waiting on the right time to give it to him. Mm-hmm. So I was his nurse again on Sunday, and I went in there, and we got to talking, and I told him, I said, you asked me to pray for you. I said, I did, and I got a word from the Lord for you. And I told him what God said, and I went on out the room. When I went, then I was on the hall passing. The aide came to me and said, 8:55, say, he going to church. I said, going to church? Where he going to church at? I don't know, but he said he going to church. I said, well, who coming to pick him up or whatever? So anyway, I'm like, well, I don't know. So I went in there. Sure enough, he was trying to get his wheelchair to get in. I said, well, let me do your medicines and stuff. Showing up. I said, you got a ride? Yeah, they out there waiting on me. So I got everything done. He said, he said, what you told me this morning? He said, that did something to me. He said, I got to go to church. He said, I got to go. That did something to me. And I got to get myself together. And I give God praise because he's the second one that God had me speak to, and they came back and testified how that touched their life and how it was right on time. So I just God, and my desire is to light that place up so until everybody needs shade because the glory is just that bright.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. And that's what it's about, you guys. It's a work full, like you at your work is a place full of sinners there. And if
that's right.
You're there.
Right.
You're there for a reason to touch their lives.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
So remember that. Next time you want to complain, like, God, get me off this place. Did you tell anybody about Jesus yet while you're there?
Right.
So far, you know. So that's awesome. God is doing a work through you, woman of God, at that place. That's a blessing.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
Amen. All right. So can you get one more testimony?
Hello.
How you doing?
Hi, this is Andrea from Mississippi. I got
How
a testimony.
Doing, Andrea? Yeah.
Andrea.
Yeah.
Okay. Look, you had, I think it was last week or maybe 2 weeks ago, you had prophesied to me that, you know, you saw where, you know, God was going to bless me with different kind of different income streams, you know, coming through. And I was on one of my cousins. They have their own church and they have a prayer line. And so there's this lady that all of a sudden, you know, she started. I was looking at her on Facebook, and she started talking about, I can help you with making T-shirts. I got vendors for hair. I got vendors for makeup. Selling purses and prophets. You prophesied. You saw me doing all selling that those products now from my car. And I say, Lord, you know, I thank you, you know, because I've been going through and going through. You know, I hadn't started the process yet, but still that's a beginning and that's a confirmation. You know, I've talked with her and we're going to get together. And, you know, she's in another state, but still she have her, you know, webinars and different things. And she's going to help me that way. And, you know, I'm just, you know, thankful, you know, for you being obedient. You know, releasing that word, and I'm just, you know, excited and ready to go, ready to get started, because I'm tired of the place, like I told God, I'm tired of this place where I'm at, struggling day by day, you know, just struggling, and I know it's better for me. You know, I'm a child of God, and I know it's better for me.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And
Amen. And I thank God. Amen for that work coming to fruition. Amen. And someone on here, you next. You got words too. I prophesy we're going to see manifestation.
I'm next. Amen.
That's powerful.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. So let's go ahead and get some prayer requests. Push star 6 if you like prayer. And intercessors, this is a time for you to pray. And as you pray on someone else's behalf, just know God is moving on your behalf. Amen. So we're going to be praying. All right. Is it Markeisha? How are you?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
Good. I miss you in the book class.
Yeah, I have to go back and watch it.
Okay.
I was out of school on Saturday. But however, I need prayer. I was looking for a job and I had a job interview. It was actually today, and you know, I won't hear back from them. But I've been praying about it, you know. But I just need, you know, prayer for that.
Amen, Father. We just give you praise and we just thank you, Father God, that you are Jehovah Jireh. You are our provider, and God, we thank you, God, for providing all of our needs, God. This woman of God needs a job, Father. So, God, I just ask you right now, we ask you, Father God, Lord, that you just bless her with favor, bless her to get the job, bless her, Father God, to, Lord, just get the favor and just to get employed, Father God. We thank you, God, for the orientation and just her getting everything she needs, Lord. I thank you, Father God, that even right now my eyes are opening and I see her walking the halls. I see her shaking the supervisor's hand. I see her getting the badge. I see her, Lord God, getting everything she needs for the job. So, God, I thank you, Father God, that all is well in the name of Jesus. You'll get the job, Lord God, and I just give you praise, God, in advance, Lord. And I thank you, Father God, that there will be no more lack. There will be no more struggle. Lord, I speak increase in her life. I speak stability in her life. I prophesy over her feet that her feet will, Lord God, be stable in this season, God, that her feet will be like the either the hind feet want to cure places in the name of Jesus. God, I give you praise and honor that she will no more fall or stumble, but you have her, God. You are raising her up, and God is lifting you up as never before. And God, I just thank you, God, for shielding her, protecting her, and strengthening her now for your glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, amen. Amen. But my eyes were open. I just seen you shaking someone's hand, and I see, even right now, I see paperwork being signed and things like that, and just the name tag or and you just walking, whatever, the hallways or something like that, just walking. Amen. So I know God has a job for you, and I decree and declare orientation is right around the corner for you. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
God bless. All right, Sylvia, how can we pray for you today?
Hello?
How are you?
I'm good. I'm okay. I'm just getting some food, getting ready to go back to work so I don't have to buy nothing because I'm always spending money. But, yeah, I just want you to pray, you know, my strength in the Lord and that I will go deeper and he will strengthen me. I ask for him to bless me with discernment and wisdom. And remove people out of my life that's not meant for me and replace them with people that is meant for me. And I ask him to just order my steps and God begin to just, you know, do what he want me to do.
Amen. Awesome, awesome. So intercessor was purpose, Sylvia. Father God, we just thank you, God, for your daughter. We thank you, Father God, that, Lord, as she draws nigh to you, you will draw nigh to her, God. And God, I thank you, Father God, for the intimacy, God, between you and her to be ever so closely knitted together, Father God.
Jesus.
Lord God, that she'll just be so engulfed in your presence and your glory that,
you,
Lord, that you will only allow the right people to be in her life and you won't allow anyone to connect to her. You won't allow the counterfeits to come in her life anymore. You won't allow people, Lord, that don't mean her any good to attach yourself to her, Father God, but you will put your glory around her and shield her, God, as never before, God. And God, we thank you, Father God, that the wrong people are leaving her life right now. And God, you are sending the right people because, God, she is your child. We thank you, God, for the hunger and the zeal rising up inside of her, that she is hungering and thirsting after righteousness, so she shall be filled. We thank you, God, for a desire to go deeper, a hunger for your word, a hunger for prayer. God, I thank you that she's going to be devoted to you as never before, and be on fire for you. I thank you, God, that you're going to use her right on her job, Father. Use her to minister to the children. Use her, God, to minister to her coworkers. Use her, Father God, to minister to the people she crossed paths with. God, I thank you, God, that the word of knowledge and the gifts of the Holy Spirit just be in operation through her, God. You will use her in the supernatural realm. You will use her, God, in ways that she thought you would never use her, Father. Lord, I just thank you, Father, right now, Lord, that you'll give her wisdom and increase the discernment on her life, that she'll make better choices and she won't get yoked up with the wrong connections ever again. Lord, I thank you, God, that she will know how to save and you'll show her how to invest her money, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God, right now, Father God, for increasing her life. We thank you for favor. We thank you, God, for opportunities, Lord.
Thank you.
To preach your gospel, God. We thank you, Father God, that you will order in her steps. Keep her from harm, God. Keep her from danger. Keep her from tragedies, God. Lord, send angels around her to protect
thank
her.
You,
to guard her steps, Lord. God, we thank you, Father God, right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Lord, and I thank you.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
I see a young man, and you know who I'm talking about. I see a heart change. Amen. I see
say
a heart change. I see a young man, and I don't want to say his name because you know who I'm talking about. I met him before, and I see him on his knees, heart change, repenting, just saying I'm sorry. Him humbling with some pride there, but I see him being humbled. His heart changing and just crying out. And, yes, but, yes, just let me press in. God, I'm seeing it. I'm just seeing it. Hold on.
Thank you, God.
I see the young man. I do see separation from you and him. Just let the Lord just work on him.
Amen. And I know that's a desire in your heart, but let the Lord work on him, and then the Lord will allow you guys to get reconnected. You know, so let God work on him, because he still has a lot of questions about the Bible. He still has a lot of questions about God, and he's still in the infant stage of the searching. But I see the Lord humbling him. I see the Lord causing him to get on his knees, just to seek his face. There's a lot of questions there. All right, so allow God to just process him and work on him.
Amen.
All right, so that's what I do see.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right, God bless.
Thank you. You too.
All right, Andrea? Andrea? Andrea?
Okay, I'm sorry. I was on mute. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Okay, this is my prayer request, and it's really my desire. You know, I'm in the apartment, and, you know, I'm behind on the rent. But my thing is, I know I'm going to have, you know, I'm going to, you know, move. I always wanted my own place.
That's what I heard.
I'm just praying. Yeah, you did tell me that, too. I'm praying that, you know, my credit is bad, you know, in the natural eyesight of man. You know, I've tried to get pre-approved, you know, for a house. But I'm asking God, this time when I go back, to give me favor.
Yeah.
You know, because I like where I stay, the apartment, but that's not where my destiny is.
That's right.
You know, and then I also, you know, you had prophesied, you know, that you see, I think you said about a young man coming in my life too, you know, but I told God, you know, whatever his will is, but, you know, right now I got to do what I got, you know what I'm saying, for me and my daughter.
Yeah.
And I'm just wanting to make better for me and my daughter so she don't have to see me struggling anymore, so she don't have to be in want, but my desire right now is that God get me approved. You know, because I've already talked with a man. He does houses, and he has a house. And I spoke with his wife, and she said, this will be the perfect house for you. It was a burnt house, and what he does, he gut them out and make them like they're brand new.
Amen.
And he don't charge much. And I'm just asking God to give me favor with my credit.
You know what I hear? The Lord said he's going to give you a down payment so you can get approved. That's what I do here. But we'll definitely pray for your credit. That's what I heard. I heard when you said move, before you even said move, she said she got to move. Then you said move, and then then you said tell her I have a down payment for her so she can get approved. So whatever you want to apply for, just know that God's going to provide the money for your down payment so you can get approved. So that's what I hear. And I just feel the glory burning on my face. My face is getting hit with glory right now. But, Father, we just lift up the woman of God. And, God, we know how yesterday you bypassed credit, Lord, for the other woman of God to get that car. God, she had a low credit score. And we know, God, in Andrew's case, you can do the same. Because if you do it before, you can do it again because you are no respecter of person. So, God, we just thank you, Father God. Yes, God, we call forth the finances for it, the down payment, God, so she can get approved. You told me this, Holy Spirit. You just told it to me. So, God, we just decree it now, right now, her circumstances, God, that when she goes back and she talks to this man with this house, God, we thank you that she will have money to put down, God, and God will open up the heavens over her life and just cause favor, God, so she can get in this home, Father, and, God, she and her daughter can live in a better place, location, Lord, that's more affordable, and we thank you that she won't have to struggle anymore. We just give you praise, God, in advance. So, God, we thank you that all is well. We thank you, God, for the income that's coming, the multiple streams of income that's coming, and we thank you that whatever she needs, God, if she needs money for a startup cost to invest in her business, we call that money forth now, in Jesus' name.
We thank you, Father God, that our businesses belong to you. We vow and we submit these businesses unto you, God. And we say these are your businesses, God. So since these are your businesses, God, you're going to prosper them, God. And you're going to allow these businesses to be kingdom businesses, God, to be able to generate other opportunities of employment, God, for other people, God. And so you can bless this woman of God so she can do more for you. So, God, we just give you praise and honor, God. And bless this woman of God with peace and just stability as never before. And, God, we give you praise and honor in the name of Jesus. And I just thank you, Father God, that even right now, Lord, I even see just the change that used to be around her. Those bars of brass and those bars of those gates, of those doors of imprisonment are open up. It was like I was in a prison and I saw the prison doors open. So God, I just thank you that the prison doors are open, Lord, and those doors of just imprisonment are opening over in her life, God, that she would no longer be in bondage. She would no longer feel like she's in a prison, God, or a jail cell that's stuck and confined. But those prison doors are opening up for the woman of God, and I mean to create freedom, God, freedom in her finances. She no longer has to stress and worry and be a charitable case, God. That's something that in her heart. She said, God, I'm tired of people looking at me as I'm a charity case, Lord. And I thank you, Father, for just blessing her, God, with a new employment status, God. Lord, that she just be so well off, God. She can be a blessing unto your body, God. She can bless other people, Lord, that's needing, because she know how it feels. So, God, we thank you for giving her a powerful testimony for your glory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, yeah. God. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Lord, I thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, God.
Amen.
Yeah, thank you, Lord. Yeah,
thank you, Lord. I feel glory. Amen. I feel glory.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Jesus. Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. So don't even, God has you. Amen. I know he's able to provide the money. Trust me. He's going to provide the money. Because let me tell you something. I have done like 2 conferences, and God say, you know, you're going to pay this venue off early. And he blessed me to do it every time. You know, so when God say he's going to provide the money, he's going to provide that money for that down payment. So he has you. I'm so confident in that. And what else I saw? I don't know. But, those prison doors opening, amen, I believe it's a transition and a shift in your life in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord. I receive it in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. All right. God bless you, woman of God. We love you.
Bless you. Love you.
All right, you guys. I want you to be expecting. Thank you for touching in green. Just know that God is moving on your behalf. I decree and declare the Job 42:11 principle, that as Job prayed for his friends, God gave him double. For his trouble, or his latter days were better than his former days. I decree that in your life. I speak God's blessings upon you. I speak God's grace upon you in his favor. So we'll see you tomorrow at the next call. God bless.